Hello, this is Brian Sykes with AI Explore. I wanted to introduce you to a new feature inside of Midjourney called InPainting. And with InPainting, what I want to do is show you exactly how this thing works. To begin with, you want to go into your settings and make sure Remix is open and active. The way you do that is do / settings, easy enough, and press the return key. Inside of settings, you want to make sure Remix mode is selected and that you're using the latest model 5.2. This is key. If you do not have Remix mode turned on, it's going to allow you to walk through the process of what looks like you can make edits, but you won't be able to prompt or add the details that's going to give you the variations to your prompt. Okay, so with Remix mode turned on, we can actually work from any existing image inside of Midjourney that we've already created, or we can start from scratch. I'm actually going to grab one that I've already done in the past. And so here's a collection of images that I think are pretty cool. And I'm going to grab number one from this selection and go ahead and render it out. I like this image. It's rather complex with a lot of story being told in the visuals. And there's our image. Here's a guy sitting at a table and got a lot of emotion showing up in this thing. So how do we use the InPainting feature? Well, you'll notice underneath the image, we've got very strong and very subtle. These were both made available with version 5.2. But what I want to do is the next one in the list, which is very region. Because I've got settings and inside of that, I've got the Remix mode turned on. When I choose very region, what it's going to do is it's given me an option of a rectangular marquee and a lasso tool where I can make selections and then define what's going to go inside of that selection area. So on the table here, I think it'd be really interesting to have a bowl of something or a cup of something that's steaming. So I'm going to draw a marquee, pretty good size marquee area here. And the area that I've selected is where I've defined the image is going to be inpainted. So I'm going to select all of this stuff here and delete it because I want to put inside of this what I'm looking for. So bowl of alien slop soup, hot and steaming tentacles. Okay. So I'm telling it I want a bowl of alien slop soup, hot and steaming, tentacles and other gunk visible in the glass bowl of soup. And I'll go ahead and apply this. It lets me know the job's been submitted so I can close. I'll close both of those. So this will begin rendering the inpainting element to my image. Because it's inpainting, it's not rechanging the structure or the size of the image that I'm working with. So it's going to only be working with the space that's been defined by the marquee. Okay, so these are rather interesting. I kind of like number two the best, even though it looks a little strange. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and manipulate this a little bit more. We can do very region. And what I wanna do is I wanna have something coming out of this. Since this guy's eyes are somewhat looking up, then I think it'd be interesting to turn this into an alien creature coming out of the bowl. If you've got a prompt area, and excuse me, if you've got an area already marquee selected and you do not want that to be selected, you can hit the little recirc arrow up here in the top left corner and it removes that selection. Now what I want to do is I'm going to draw a marquee that's above this shape here and I'm going to add to it. So I've drawn the marquee with a rectangle. I can come in and add other elements. So I can expand on that space. Alien creature climbing out of the bowl of alien soup. All right, so I'm going to close that and we'll see what this thing comes up with. It seems to be a total disregard for my request to create an alien creature. So I'm going to come back up here and do another variation on this one, simply because it does not like what I'm asking for. Alien squid climbing out of the bowl of alien soup. So while sometimes you can render and get some pretty good results, sometimes it just totally disregards the things that you're asking for. So even though I explicitly said I wanted an alien climbing out of the bowl, even though there's some stuff showing up inside of this bowl from the first render, it ignored it altogether. So I'm modifying this a little bit to say alien squid climbing out of the bowl. Okay, while this one's running, I'm gonna pull up another process here I created. So on this one, I did thick impasto painting of a waterfall into a pool and stream. Background of the North Carolina mountains, aspect ratio of 16:9, and it gave me these four results. Now from those results, I upscaled number one. With this selection, I did the very region impromptu, and I asked it to create thick impasto painting of children playing and splashing in the water. And these are the results that I got from that. And I like number one the best, so I upscaled it. And what I decided to do is not leave it here, but I made a selection back here behind the rocks above the waterfall and told it to create a dragon. Here's the options that it gave me. And I like number two the best because its body's still in the water, where number one and number three just has a head floating down. And number four, there's not much of a body to go with this guy. So number two was the one that worked for me. And here's what it gave me. This was kind of a fun render. Also, after you run a prompt and you're done, so in this case, I told it to create the dragon. The area selected, I told it to go ahead and do a labradoodle. So in place of where the dragon is, it dropped a gigantic labradoodle. Again, it doesn't look at the other details when it's adding the elements that you ask for. It only matches in the spot that it's being placed, but it does not look at scale and perspective and throw things into proper alignment. So it's not going to put a little bitty labradoodle in proportion to the scale of the children. In fact, it's just going to create a dog where you've asked for it to go. All right, so this one's almost done, and it looks like it's going to give me a little bit of something to work with here. So yep, there's the alien octopus squid-like legs here that's sticking out. That's what I kind of like the best. So that's number three. So I'm gonna upscale number three. All right, and then when you look at this image, you'll notice that this guy's hands are messed up. If this were a fist and he had his hand closed around the fist, that might work, but I'm gonna fix this. I'm gonna do vary region. Now in Photoshop, I might go in and make the selection and tell it to edit. So I'm gonna see if I can select this. I'm interested in how to describe this to get it right. In this case, this is just a guess. But you notice I'm able to vary region, do inpainting multiple times to get the results that I'm after. There is a bit of a delay from a request to a result. And while I love the visual quality of what I can get from Midjourney, this slight delay can be a little bit on the frustrating side simply because we've got some time. Okay, of those, number two is gonna be my best option. Again, it's not perfect, but it's very workable. So here we go. All right, so here's our final image, and this hand works well in proportion and perspective. The guy's eyes are definitely looking at this alien-like creature sticking out of his bowl. So this was kind of a fun image, and that's this Midjourney's new inpainting feature. Have some fun with it, explore it, and I'd love to see what you guys come up with. Have a wonderful day.